Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Hi, this is Dr. Dabosky. Welcome to Chapter 4. In today's short video instruction, I'm going to be covering the basics of internal controls over cash and the primary internal control procedure that we have for ensuring that cash is safeguarded is what we call preparing what we call bank reconciliations. So in the following short video, let's get into this right away. So one thing we always want to remember about cash, it's always king. Or for the ladies, queen. So let's not, differentiate. It's either king or queen, but cash is very important to corporations. The learning objectives in this short little video primarily will only cover learning objectives 1, 2, 3 through 7. Please note that I will only be focusing, because of the short-term nature of this course and the fact that it's online, I'm giving you a short instructional video on the most difficult part of the chapter, which is dealing with bank reconciliations. Although you should remember that there's another internal control procedure over cash in which it's called maintaining a petty cash fund. It's pretty basic. It's covered in the book in detail. You are familiar or responsible to be familiar with everything that is included in the textbook. However, I'm trying to help you with the more difficult stuff, which is the bank reconciliation. Let's cover a little bit about cash and why it's important. We know that cash is especially susceptible to theft and misuse. What does cash include? Well, it includes basically currency, coins, checks, money orders, and cash equivalents. These are basically investments like a CD with a short-term maturity of 90 days or less. Companies must keep very detailed cash receipts and cash disbursement journals, and procedures have to be in place. Internal controls over cash include two primary things: bank reconciliations and petty cash funds. In this video, I'm going to be focusing on bank reconciliations because for some students, this can be a very difficult topic. I ask that you pay attention to this video and that you practice any homework assigned and to know the basics of outstanding checks, outstanding deposits, and things that are used in the reconciliation process. So generally, a bank reconciliation involves the following. Generally, what happens is the amount of cash that's shown on a bank statement. This is something that you get from your bank, either electronically if you opt out to get paper bank statements, or they're sent to you via mail. And the bank statement will almost always differ from the amount of cash that you might have recorded if you write things down in a little checkbook register to keep track of what you're spending. A lot of times your balances between what the bank thinks says you have and what you have in your own recordings are going to be different. So the bank and the company balances are going to be different. Why? Because number one, the company has transactions that are yet to be recorded by the bank, and then the bank has transactions that are yet to be recorded by the company. Therefore, in order to reconcile this, there needs to be a reconciliation of these differences to maintain the accuracy and the control of our cash. So let's look first at the cash transactions that are recorded by the company but not the bank. There are two that fall under this one, and we call these the outstanding items. So it's the deposits outstanding, and the checks outstanding. Deposits outstanding represent deposits that the company has made at the end of the period, generally probably on the very last day of the month, but which the bank has not credited the company's account yet for those funds. Checks outstanding are checks where the company has written the check, has mailed them to the vendor, but the vendor has not presented them for payment against the company's bank account. So the bank does not know that these checks have been written. And then on the other side of the transactions, this is what we call cash transactions recorded by the bank but not the company. These include service charges, interest earned, cash collections from the company's customers that the bank would receive but the company doesn't know about these, or what we call the bad checks, NSF, non-sufficient funds. I want you to kind of think of a bank reconciliation, and using a crude sports metaphor, is like a boxing match. There's two corners. On the bank side corner, that represents the outstanding items. There's only two items that go into the bank side. That's your deposits outstanding and your checks outstanding. On the company side, there are at least four different types of reconciling items that are going to be needed to be accounted for. So once these differences are accounted for, the bank balance of cash should equal the company's balance for cash. Let's look at a quick example of a bank reconciliation. I want you to notice the bank balance says $9,000. This would come directly from the bank statement. However, the company's book balance says that the company has $5,000. Who's correct? Why are these different? However, we have to, in order to maintain good internal controls over cash, we must reconcile this difference. Other information that we found on the bank statement are that we found that there are checks written by the company not processed by the bank. What are these called, do you think? How about a note collected by the bank for $1,000? Service fees? Cash received by the company not yet deposited in the bank? And then customers' checks incorrectly recorded at $100 instead of $250. NSF check, bad check, returned for $600. Let's compute the company's cash balance and make an adjusting entry. So the first thing we're going to do is start on the bank side. We're in this boxing match. We're in the bank corner. Remember, the only thing that goes on the bank side is simply outstanding. So that means we need to take the outstanding checks and the outstanding deposits, and we need to either add them or subtract them depending on whether they're in or not in the company, the bank balance. So the outstanding checks, these checks written by the company not processed by the bank. That means the company has taken them out of its book balance, but the bank doesn't know they exist, so they're still in the bank balance. So in order to reconcile from the bank to the book balance, we need to do the same thing on the bank side that the company did. The company subtracted them. So that means outstanding checks are always going to be subtracted. That means outstanding deposits, since the company would have added it into its balance, that means in order to reconcile the two, we're going to have to add them into the bank balance, because we have to be doing the same thing on both sides. So that's one way of thinking about it. So we always will add deposits outstanding to the bank balance, and we will always subtract outstanding checks. That will give us an adjusted balance of the bank of $5,500. Now let's go to the other corner of the boxing match, which is the company corner. And on the company side, we're going to have to reconcile for all of those items that the bank knew about, but the company did not know about them until the end of the period when it received its bank statement. So let's take the note collected by the bank of $1,000. See, the bank already included the $1,000 in the $9,000. The company doesn't know about it yet, so we must add it back in. The check error, this was overly deducted from the balance of the company. So in order to reconcile for this $150 check error, we must add it back into the book balance. We are going to subtract service fees. Think of this as like a debit card fee or an ATM fee or a wire transfer fee, where the bank takes it out automatically out of the company's account. But the company doesn't know about these fees or generally worry about them to the end of the period. So we need to subtract them because the bank already took them out of the $9,000, so we need to take them out of our book balance. And then finally, we deposited a check from a customer in our $5,000, but when it got presented to the bank for payment, it was a bad check. The customer did not have enough money to cover that check. So therefore, we have to back out the NSF check. If we do these transactions, we'll see also now that both of these amounts are equal. We see the $5,500 is equal on both the bank side and the company side. So the correct cash balance would be $5,500. That does require, though, that since we had $5,000, we're going to need a $500 adjustment to cash. Well, in order to make that adjustment, we must make a reconciling adjustment for these. Why do we have to do this? Well, because these are adjustments, and if we don't record them physically, the book balance will never be equal, will be up to speed with the bank. So in order to do that, we just go through our company side adjusting entries and we'll increase or decrease cash for each one of these items. So the service fee obviously is an expense. We would expense it. We're going to go ahead and reinstate the accounts receivable, because when we received this $600, we would have credited AR and debited cash. But since it's a bad check, we have to put the AR back on our books because the customer still owes us. We know that we need to debit cash for 500 to get from 5,000 to 5,500. That's our plug. We're going to go ahead and credit our notes receivable because the bank collected this money, so we can't carry the receivable since the customer paid us. So we're going to credit the notes receivable. And then finally, we're going to pick up an additional $150 of revenue for this check error because we recorded it at the wrong amount. By doing this, we would then have our cash account equal to what our bank is showing. The adjusted balance would be $5,500. As you can see, this can be a rather difficult subject, but to keep this video short and light, please review this and please be aware of the deposits outstanding. The checks outstanding are always on the bank side. Deposits outstanding are added. Outstanding checks are subtracted. And then on the company side, we are going to reconcile for those items which the bank has recorded but the company has not. Again, this is one important process of maintaining internal controls over cash. I hope this video and example will be helpful. Thanks for listening and have a great day.